obstacles goes round and around. Go, don't even worry about it. Don't get so downhearted. Life is sunny and cloudy, round and around. Go, we got to go. It's time to grow. Through obstacles round and around. We go, don't even worry about it. Don't get so downhearted. Life is sunny and cloudy, round and around. We go. Life is getting tough, don't you be giving up. Whether it's silly stuff or even if it's serious. We're way past midnight, so now that sunlight will shine through your window to bring back in the light in your eyes. Yeah, we got to go, yeah. Got to go, it's time to grow. Through obstacles round and around we go. Don't even worry about it, don't get so downhearted. Life is sunny and cloudy, round and around we go. We got to go, it's time to grow. Through obstacles round and around. Don't even worry, don't worry, don't worry about it. Cause round and around.
Put our problems in a bag.
Which bag would you grab? Would you wanna trade? Would you take on what you had? Would you hate your cards and even fold your hand? Or open up your heart, grateful for what you have? Everyone's got their problems. Let's focus on the good we can solve. Whether it's
we will begin in about 5 minutes, so if people want to start making their way to their seats, we will begin in around 5 minutes.
We got to go, it's time to grow. Do obstacles round and around we go. Don't even worry about it, don't get so downhearted. Life is sunny and cloudy, round and around we go. Giving up's not an option, so come on and climb this mountain with me. With all of your friends surrounding, we have found that life's worth living again. You don't have to be afraid you're gonna fall apart. Sometimes life's a masterpiece, you paint it in the dark. And that's when you know how beautiful you are. When you smile through your scars. So we got to go, it's time to grow. Through obstacles round and around we go. Don't even worry about it, don't get so downhearted. Life is sunny and cloudy, round and around we go. We got to go, it's time to grow. Through obstacles round and around we go. Don't even worry about it, don't get so downhearted. Life is sunny and cloudy, round and around we go. Yeah, yeah. When life is getting tough, don't you be giving up. Whether it's silly stuff or even if it's serious. We're way past midnight, so now that sunlight will shine through your window to bring back in the light in your eyes. Yeah, we got to go, yeah, we got to go. It's time to grow. Through obstacles round and around we go. Don't even worry about it, don't get so downhearted. Life is sunny and cloudy, round and around we go. We got to go, it's time to grow. Through obstacles round and around.
We are going to begin in 1 minute, so seniors, make sure you're taking your positions, and the board and faculty, that you're taking your positions as well. Okay, at this time, we are going to begin the senior class of 2023 graduation commencement ceremony. Please all rise for the entry of colors. Remain standing as we welcome the 2023 graduating class of Grace Christian Academy. Stephen Abella Adriatico. Ryan Medina De Proza. Pagan Irene Elliott. Akari Horita. Dana Grace Howard. Jian Zhang. Soleil Jolene Lamar. Yuvin Park. Ron Ryu. Catriel Lialing Malone Soares. Susana Nieves Mofnas Villagomez. And Vicky Wong Chow. And let us now welcome the board, administrators, staff, and faculty of Grace Christian Academy. Remain standing for the anthems led by the senior class of 2023. Please remain standing as we welcome Ms. Lila Portuguese for the invocation.
God, Father in heaven, the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, we thank you, O God, Lord, and we acknowledge your very presence in the midst of us. As we celebrate this with our seniors, O God, Lord, we ask your Holy Spirit, O God, Lord, to be with us, to move in a very special way, O God. And thank you, O God, Lord, for these graduating students, O God, Lord, for their dedication, their hard work, O God, Lord. And we know, O God, Lord, without you, O God, Lord, this celebration will not be possible. And we ask, O God, Lord, as they are entering, O God, Lord, in their new journey of life, O God, that you may continue to guide, continue to give them wisdom, O God, Lord, in every step that they will make, O God, Lord, will be guided by you. And also in every decision, O God, will be filtered by you, O God, Lord. And we thank you for our parents, O God, Lord, for their hardship, their sacrifices, O God, Lord, that they have given, O God, Lord, to their kids. Thank you for the faculty and staff, O God, Lord, for giving more than what they can give, O God, Lord Jesus. And we thank you, O God, Lord, that we can celebrate, O God, Lord, this night, O God, Lord. And we thank you, bless, Lord, the speaker, Lord, that your anointing will flow, O God, and your word will not only be heard, but it will be planted, O God, Lord, in the filter soil. We thank you, Jesus, as we commit this night unto you. Have your way, and may your name be lifted up, for we ask this, O God, Lord, in Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you, Miss Lila. You may all be seated. On behalf of GCA, I would like to welcome you to this year's 2023 graduating ceremony service. I am honored to introduce and talk to you about and welcome our board chairman, Reverend Michael Rogers, our board members, Beatrice Fatialofa and Benjamin Rivero as well. Thank you for being with us tonight. This theme was selected specifically by the seniors. It was truly from their hearts. They wanted to thank everyone, the community that has surrounded them throughout their entire lives, whether that's family, friends, extended family, close family, anyone who has invested in them and given them just so much time and effort to make them the people that they are today as they're walking down the aisle and getting their diplomas. They also, our verse, which you'll hear shortly, is also just recognizing that even though we have had so many influences in our life, God plant, he grows. He grows the seeds that are planted. And they just wanted to thank everyone and recognize that as they move forward, that God's got them, that everything's going to be okay, no matter what the future holds. And so we welcome you to communally cultivated. It really is. It takes a village. And there's no better proof than that than with the family and the friends that have surrounded these seniors. So we thank you for being with us to celebrate them. We thank you for your time and your effort just investing in them for their entire lives. At this time, I would like to welcome Mokmin Kim to read the scripture for this evening.
First Corinthians 3:7, for neither the one who plants nor the one who waters is everything, but it is only God who makes things grow. First Corinthians 3:7.
Thank you, Mokmin. Before we, actually in your program at this point is where we get into the awards for the students, but we're gonna go off script for a minute here, and there's a parent that we would like to thank this evening. If I could call Mrs. Roxy Lamar to the stage, please, for a moment. Just for a moment. She's bringing her She's known for her videos, so she's bringing her phone with her. Mrs. Lamar, we want to thank you for many things that you've helped us with throughout the years here at the school, but this is specifically, we had a, I think she's recording, are you recording? She is recording, okay. A situation with our yearbook last year that we weren't able to get it completed, and she volunteered all on her own to finish the yearbook from last school year, and that's a big undertaking, and we just wanted to say thank you to you in front of everyone. Can we just give her a round of applause? So at this time, we are going to move forward into the many, many, many awards for tonight. We are going to start with athletics, but we will also go into academics and other extracurricular activities and competitions, and we would like to recognize at the end of every school year. To present the awards is Ms. Beth Ann Nunez, our principal, with the help of Ms. Rose. We're going to begin with the high school girls volleyball team. Soleil Lamar. Catrielle Soares. Adrian Elliott. And Vicky Wongi Chow. Let's give them another round of applause. These are our champions. We would now like to award the most inspirational player. Please give a warm round of applause for Hagen Elliott. We would also like to award the most valuable player award to Catriel Soares. Now, before we move on to our other sports, I'm going to ask our lovely ladies to please stay where you are. We have a special presentation that wanted the team as well as the coaches wanted to present these lovely ladies with. So if you are part of the team and you are here, or if you are a coach of the high school girls volleyball team, please make your way to the stage at this time. And ladies, this video is for you. Champions all the way.
Champions, my friends, and we'll keep on fighting till the end. We are the champions. We are the champions. No time for losers, 'cause we are the champions.
Give them a big round of applause. If you did not know, these ladies have never lost, right? Never. Since they started in middle school, they have been champions every single year that they have played. Now, for the team's presentation.
We wanted to prepare something. It's not anything big, but we hope that it conveys our feelings of gratitude and the fact that we're going to miss you a lot.
Oh.
Thank you, thank you. You may now be seated, ladies. These ladies are very cherished in the volleyball community here at GCA. Let's give them another round of applause. At this time, we are now going to move on to high school boys volleyball. Please put your hands together for Ryan DeProza. Captain this year as well, correct? Thank you. Give him another round of applause. It's all just him. We would now like to welcome the seniors that participated in the boys basketball team for high school. Please welcome Ryan DeProza again. And Steven Adriatico. All right, we would now like to award for the high school boys basketball team. The most improved player goes to Steven Adriatico. And the most valuable player of the school year is Ryan DeProza. Thank you, boys. Another round of applause. We would now like to recognize the high school girls basketball team for this year. So, Leia Lamar. Catriel Soares. Vicky Wong Ichao. Elena Howard. And Susana Villagomez. All right, please stay there, ladies. We would like to award the most inspirational player, Soleil Lamar. We would also like to award the most improved player of the school year, Elena Howard. They fought hard this year. So give them another round of applause. Thank you, ladies. We would now like to recognize our one senior who participated in track and field this year, Soleil Lamar. We would also like to recognize that she won first place in long jump this year. We are now, this is new for us this year. We are going to award those who participated in the co-ed badminton team. Please come to the front, Hayden Elliott. Vicky Wong Ichao. Catriel Soares. And as we called him, our honorary coach, who helped us very much, Mogmin Kim. For the badminton team this year, the most inspirational player is Vicky Wong. Thank you, badminton team. We are now moving into leadership awards. We're going to start by recognizing our class officers. And as their homeroom teacher, I must thank these officers so much for all of the hard work that they've done, everything that they've done for the class, as well as for younger students outside of our class as well. Please come to the front and give a round of applause for our treasurer, Mokmin Kim. Our secretary this year was Yubin Park. Our senior class vice president, Paigen Elliott. And our senior class president, Vicky Wong. Let's give them another round of applause. They have put in so much work this year. You would not believe it. Thank you, class officers. We would now like to recognize our National Honor Society officers. Please come up to the front. Our historian, Ron Ryu. And our National Honor Society president for this year, Ryan DeProza. These two have put in countless hours working with their team, as well as investing in the community, as well as the school. Let's give them another round of applause. And now for our student council leaders, or as we call them, STUCO leaders. Please welcome the STUCO treasurer, Susana Villagomez. Our student council secretary, Stephen Adriatico. Our student council vice president, Catriel Soares. And our student council president, Soleil Lamar. At this time, there's so much to say about these officers. Miss Beth would like to have a few words.
Going off script again, but I just want to tell you, these four students are amazing. I would have to say they are the best STUCO that we've ever had. They are trustworthy, they are hardworking, they are concerned about their fellow students, and we have been more than blessed by them this year. Can we just give them another round of applause?
It is now time for the ACSI Distinguished Christian High School Student Awards. This award is given to a student who has outstanding achievement in academics, leadership, fine arts, athletics, and Christian service. The Distinguished Christian High School Student Outstanding Achievement Award in Athletics is awarded to Paigen Elliott. Thank you, Agent. The Distinguished Christian High School Student Outstanding Achievement Award in Leadership is being awarded to Catriel Soares. Thank you, Kat. For the next award, we actually have two awardees. We just couldn't decide. So, the Distinguished Christian High School Student Outstanding Achievement Award in Christian Service is awarded to Stephen Adriatico. And Mokmin Kim. Congratulations. The Distinguished Christian High School Student Outstanding Achievement Award in Fine Arts is awarded to Elena Howard. Congratulations. For the final award in this category, we once again have two nominees. We just could not decide. So, the Distinguished Christian High School Student Outstanding Achievement Award in Academics is awarded to Soleil Lamar. And Ryan DeProza. Congratulations. I would now like to welcome Ms. Beth Ann Nunez back to the stage to present our next awards. Forgive me as I get my glasses. We are very excited this evening to have some special guests to give some wonderful awards regarding leadership. If I could please welcome to the stage Special Assistant to the Lieutenant Governor, Mr. Henry Hofschneider. Mr. Hofschneider will be presenting this evening the Lieutenant Governor's Leadership Award. This award is presented to the student who consistently demonstrates leadership in both the classroom and the community, empowering their classmates toward a common goal and inspiring the people around them to achieve their dreams. The recipient of this award this evening is Soleil Lamar. Soleil, if we could have you just stay in the center there for a moment. Thank you, Mr. Hofschneider. At this time, Soleil, if you could just stay right there in the middle. I would like to invite Captain Michael Bacher, please, to the stage. Let me just tell you a little bit. Yes, please welcome him. Captain Bacher is a retired Navy captain with 40 years of service in the Navy. I give him another round of applause, please. He is also active merchant master mariner, and he came to Saipan in 2014 as captain on ships at anchor. He is also the founder of Western Pacific Maritime Academy here on Saipan. I will now give him the microphone.
Soleil. Mr. and Mrs. Lamar, it's been a great pleasure to get to know you a little bit this year. I have, for you from the United States Naval Academy, Annapolis, Maryland. The superintendent of the United States Naval Academy takes great pleasure in recognizing with this certificate of accomplishment the selection of Soleil Zilin Lamar for an offer of appointment to the United States Naval Academy with the class of 2027. Signed, Admiral Sean S. Buck. I'll save the speech for you later.
Thank you, Captain. Thank you. Congratulations, Soleil. I would like to now call Mr. Oscar Babauta, Special Assistant to the Governor, to present the Governor's Leadership Award. And I'm going, yes, please welcome him. Let me just read this again. This award is also presented to the student who consistently demonstrates leadership in both the classroom and the community, empowering their classmates toward a common goal and inspiring the people around them to achieve their dreams. The recipient of the Governor's Leadership Award this evening is Ms. Catrielle Soares. Thank you. We are now moving on to academic honors. Students who excel in academics are recognized and honored at the end of the school year. Students are constantly and consistently encouraged to perform at their maximum potential. This program is designed to encourage students to continue striving for the highest standards set before man and before God. For consistent honor roll, students with an A or B average in all subjects with no numeric grade below an 83 per quarter per school year, please first welcome Stephen Adriatico. Hagen Irene Elliott. Eubin Park. Susana Villagomez. And Vicky Wong Yichao. Give them another round of applause. We will now award the consistent principals list, which consists of students with an A average in all subjects with no numeric grade below a 96 per quarter per school year. Please first welcome Ryan DeProza. Elena Howard.
Soleil Lamar. And Catriel Soares. Let's give them all another round of applause. That takes a lot of dedication. We now have our Loyalty Award. This award is given to students who have studied for at least 10 years consecutively at Grace Christian Academy, many of which are beyond that. 9 years. 9 years. So we'll begin with Catriel Soares, who has been with us for 9 years. Soleil Lamar, who has been with us for 10 years. Stephen Adriatico, who has been with us for 12 years. Hagen Elliott, who has been with us for 12 and a half years. And then we have one student who has been with us all along. For 13 years, we have Ryan DeProza. Give them another round of applause. Many teachers have watched them grow up since they were little. We are now going to award our character awards. We begin with the Diligence Award. This is presented to the student who serves as an exceptional example to their peers by demonstrating unwavering perseverance and persistence in schoolwork and other responsibilities and activities. The recipient of this award is Akare Horita. Our next award is the Joseph Servant Award. This is presented to a student who has shown a spirit of love, forgiveness, submission, helpfulness, cooperation, and a positive attitude towards peers, teachers, and all others. The recipient of this award is Soleil Lamar. For our Barnabas Encourager Award, it is given to a student who has been an encouragement and a support to all others that they come in contact with. This recipient is Vicky Wongichow. Now for our Christian Disciple Award. This is presented to a student who strives to live a Christ-centered life, demonstrated by reflecting the teachings of Jesus in lifestyle and commitment, showing love to others, and by sharing their faith. The recipient of this award is Stephen Adriatico.
Yeah.
We now have our Citizenship Award. This award encompasses all former descriptions of character awards. This award is presented to the student who demonstrates excellent behavior in and out of the classroom and sets a unique example of the love of Jesus. The recipient of this award is Mogmin Kim. We will now move on to the major academic awards. We will start with consistent high GPA. 12th grade students who have maintained a grade point average of 3.5 throughout the present year and two previous school years will, with having attended GCA for at least two consecutive years, being 11th and 12th grade. Please welcome Euban Park. We would like to ask the parents. No? Yes? I'm not for this one, sorry. Congratulations, Euban. We would also like to recognize Hagen Elliott. And last but not least, Vicky Wongi Chow. For the next three awards, when we call the student, we would also like the parents to come up to take a photo with your child. For the third, fourth, and fifth graduating with honors, this is awarded to those students who have earned third, fourth, and fifth highest numeric averages per school year. The graduating 12th grade student who has earned the third, fourth, and fifth highest cumulative numeric average from 9th to 12th grade and has attended GCA for all of those years. Fifth graduating with honors, put your hands together for Stephen Adriatico. Congratulations, Stephen. Our fourth graduating with honors, put your hands together for Susana Nieves Mofnes Villagomez. Congratulations, Susanna. Our third graduating with honors this school year, put your hands together for Elena Grace Howard. At this time, it is now time to award and hear the speeches from two salutatorians this year. We had a tie in the tiny, tiny details, so they very much so tied. Well, this Award is awarded to the graduating 12th grade students who have earned the second highest cumulative numeric average from 9th grade through 12th grade and has attended GCA for all of those years. The salutatorian of the graduating class earned a numeric grade of 83 or higher per subject, per quarter, per school year, and obtained the required years of residency at GCA. This year, first, salutatorian is Soleil Lamar. This time, Soleil will come and give her speech.
Good evening, faculty, staff, friends, family, honored guests, and fellow graduates. Thank you for being here to share this special time with the Grace Christian Academy class of 2023. As many of you know, my mom has been very active in my high school life, and for better or for worse, in many of my friends' lives too. She has always told me there are three major events that occur during your high school years: getting your driver's license, taking the SAT, and graduating. And now you're all here with us celebrating the last of those events, graduation. Our class decided on our graduation theme, Communally Cultivated. We wanted to pay tribute to those who have had an influence in our lives. Over these 4 years of high school, and for many of us, even going back to elementary, we have become not just classmates, but a family of friends. We are not just a school, but a cohesive community. Groups we join in middle school and high school, like NJSDA, volleyball, basketball, obtaining leadership roles, and simply being an active participant, brought us out of our comfort zones. Although we may not realize it yet, each choice we made, self-selected or imposed, has made an impact on our lives. Our class has accomplished many things we didn't think we would. We said we would go to Manigaha for a senior trip, but we expanded our imagination and created an opportunity to go to South Korea. At first, we didn't think we had the talent to put together a senior band, but with a little creativity, we did it. We did it together through hard work and dedication. All that we have done, whether inside or outside of school, has been influenced by all of you here today in one way or another. I believe I'm speaking for my class as a whole when I say GCA has prepared us well for the challenges we will face ahead in creating a life that serves our community as well as ourselves. Our past has prepared us for our future. As we enter the next stage of our lives, remember to join groups and be involved. Do not stay in your shell. Set meaningful goals for yourself and keep focused on achieving those goals. And finally, be a positive influence to others and use good judgment in how you let others influence you. So congratulations to our class, and thank you for all who have helped us. Thank you to my friends, my favorite classmates, my nanny, my mom, and my dad. Thank you.
Now, in no particular order, our second salutatorian of the evening is Catriel Soares.
Thank you.
At this time, Katria will now give us her speech.
Good evening. Winston Churchill left the impressionable words, "To improve is to change, to be perfect is to change often." Tonight, I would like to share with you all one of my greatest fears, being change itself. I've attended the same school for 9 years with the same classmates. I've undergone the same schedule of attending school, joining practices, and returning home. I come back to the same home with the same people, and we partake in similar conversations about our day. I love stability. There is peace in stability. However, moving forward requires, of course, movement. It requires breaking out of our bubble of comfort and peace in order to enforce a needed change in our lives, even with a single step. Graduating tonight is the first big step we take. As we graduates prepare to embark upon our separate journeys, I can't help but reflect on what we've been through together, the storms we face, the sorrows we shared, and the joy we've orchestrated out of the good and bad. The graduates that joined me on this very stage have become more than mere classmates to me. With so many years spent together, they have become my second family, and I'm having the hardest time imagining my next years without seeing them all in the classroom, with the boys laughing about who knows what, and the girls arguing about who knows what. However, I must remind myself that this is not a night of sadness, but one of celebration. We have endured many years of hardship that deserve recognition. We face challenges within different classes, each imparting difficulties taught in different styles. We stayed up all those late nights doing what we could to make our parents proud, especially because PowerSchool now exists to expose us. We had many highs and lows, both individually and collectively, but it never really mattered to me which season we were in so long as we were together. You were all my stability. However, it is time for us to move on. It is time for us to embrace the change and the unknown ahead of us. It is time for us to put to use the time and effort our loved ones spent on cultivating the person we have become today. Is change still a scary thing? I would say it always is to some degree. But with the people who have and continue to support us, whether near or far, change can evolve from something we fear to a welcomed unknown. At Grace Christian Academy, supportive people are not hard to find. I found unwavering support from my GSA family who went above and beyond to guide my steps. I found overwhelming amounts of love from students in other classes who simply wished the best for me and one another. Most especially, I found unconditional and unending love and support from my family, who told me I was the smartest at times when I did not feel smart, who told me I was more than enough when I did not feel like enough, and who stood by me at my lowest. All I have done to this point was done out of gratitude to each person who guided me along the way, and I vow to become someone who you all, and most especially God, can be proud of. Thank you all for being part of the community that cultivated us to this very night of celebration.
We would now like to welcome the valedictorian of 2023. This is awarded to the graduating 12th grade student who has earned the highest cumulative numeric average from 9th through 12th grade and has attended GCA for those years. The valedictorian of the graduating class earned a numeric grade of 83 or higher per subject, per quarter, per school year, and obtained the required residency at GCA. This year's valedictorian is Ryan DeProza. At this time, Ryan will share with us his speech.
To our distinguished guests, board, faculty and staff, families, friends, and of course the graduating class of 2023, good evening. This evening is one of those special nights that we will never forget. It serves as the gateway from the end of an ignorant, dependent childhood to the beginning of an independent, responsible adulthood. I cannot fully express how grateful I feel about standing here on the podium with the opportunity to emphasize the class's gratitude for the people who have cultivated us up until this point. We are greatly honored to be the class representing this school as Eagles because of its admirable characteristics. In the same way that we feel honored, we would like to honor our influencers. Firstly, we must acknowledge God's everlasting mercy, grace, and love. Without him, we are lost, constantly trying to figure out what is right. Fortunately, God's love is often reflected through our remarkable families, especially parents and guardians. Other than those times when they would rather have you bored at home, hopelessly discovering a way to entertain yourself, than spending valuable time with your friends outside of the house. Well, despite that, we appreciate your constant effort to support us in every way. Your presence alone is enough comfort and reassurance to cheerfully help us tackle a stressful day. Despite that, However, as my older brother once said before his departure, it is about that time for us to escape from our cocoons in order to fly and become that beautiful butterfly. Secondly, we must acknowledge the school, Grace Christian Academy, for setting us up for our imminent success. As a student since K-5, which you already know, which was about 13 years, I would say that I'm a credible source in the judgment of the school's faculty and staff. With that being said, I can confidently say that I have always sensed their concern in our grades, behavior, and our lousy habits. All of the teachers that I've had, including the principals and the rest of the staff, possess benevolence and a desire for us to not only succeed, but to go beyond their expectations, and for that we truly appreciate. And lastly, we cannot forget about our friends who have shaped our characteristics and provided something to lean on at times when we are vulnerable. To those that accentuated our flaws and critiqued us in arguably unacceptable ways, while conversely displaying affection, we greatly appreciate them for being the catalyst of our improvement. With these people, God, our families, this school, and our friends, we are delightfully, communally cultivated. And as for this batch of a few, yet incredible students, well, to put everyone into perspective, nearly our entire high school was affected by the pandemic. While it may have saved us from a geometry project, it created online classes. Consequently, it was rather difficult for us to add to our class funds. Despite that, we still managed to have enough money to spare, even after taking a trip to Korea. With that being said, I believe that we do not realize how remarkable we are and will become. I would like to highlight a comment that Ms. Julie had on these students. She stated that God spoke to her and revealed the fact that these students are leaders. While some of us are currently finding out if that's accurate, I believe it to be true. I believe that if we walk with God, then we inevitably possess the traits of a profound leader. And I believe that if we possess the traits of a profound leader, then we are comfortable with being ourselves, no longer insecure. And I believe that if we are no longer insecure, then we can embrace the unknown. And I know, not believe, I know, that if we embrace the unknown, then there's truly nothing to be afraid of. I'm excited to see the graduating class of 2023's potentials surpassed, goals accomplished, and fears extinguished. But for now, let us celebrate this memorable night. Thank you all.
Let's give them all another round of applause. This batch is truly special.
So we're proud to award them with all that they have earned. At this time, I would like to welcome Eubin Park to introduce this evening's speaker.
So we have a very special guest speaker with us here tonight, who I feel very honored to be introducing. Not only is he a former computer science teacher and the current board chairman of our school, but he's been a guiding factor for students in GCA for a few years and continuing. We hold him very dear here at GCA. He's tall, he's handsome. Please welcome Pastor Michael Rogers.
We practiced that. Not the handsome thing, but I appreciate it. Praise God. The passage that the seniors have chosen to focus on tonight is found in 1 Corinthians 3:7. And I want to read it one more time, even though we've heard it several times tonight. It says, "So neither the one who plants nor the one who waters is anything, but only God who makes things grow." Father, I ask, Lord, tonight, as we gather for one last message to the seniors, God, I pray that you would impact their hearts. You would strengthen them. You would encourage them, God. And Lord, you would help them, Father. Lord, because we're never done growing. We thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. As Ms. Julie, the senior advisor, had sent the passage and explained to me, the seniors, this passage of scripture had been something that had resonated with them as they contemplated growth, as they contemplated growth throughout the year. And this topic is something that I'm happy to hear about. I remember my freshman year of college at Evangel University in Springfield, Missouri. I met another freshman. He was 65 years old. His name was Hugh, and he was a retired Air Force fighter pilot. And I remember meeting him, and I was just so struck. I was like, "What are you doing here?" A man with so many years of experience. And he said to me, "Michael, you're never done growing. You're never done learning." Of course, I was just 18 years old, and I was like, "Yes, sir, you're absolutely right." That's the message, that we're never done growing. We're never done developing who we are. Even until the day we die, we're always changing. I believe it was William S. Burroughs who said, "When you stop growing, you start dying." John Maxwell, he tells a story how these tourists were traveling through a European village. It was a very picturesque village. And he said that some of the tourists stopped and asked an elderly man who was leaning against a fence, they said, "Sir, was there any great men or great women that were born here?" And of course, the way they asked it, it was kind of rude. And he said, "Nope, only babies." Now, although that statement may be a little comical, the truth is there are no great men or women born. This is something that develops in our life. We grow into the image of what God has for us. It's the truth that success in life only comes after time and preparation. Parents, family, you all have entrusted your sons and your daughters to us at GCA. To teach and to minister to them. We, with the best of our abilities, we've trained them in a biblical fashion. We've taught them science, literature, math, music, art, computer science, even for two of those students over there. They're cringing because they had a hard time in my class. But more than that, you've also trusted us as we have poured into their life the message of Christ. The greatness that we want for them is something that can only be grown. In the passage that was selected for us today, Paul, he's using a farming metaphor as a way to emphasize a number of things relevant to a situation within the church of Corinth. And what we have to understand is that Paul planted this church in Corinth on a missionary trip. He spent some 18 months ministering to the people there, devoting time and teaching them and teaching the new believers. And verse 5 says that Paul, he indicated that this very ministry, the activities that Paul and later Apollos were involved in, they were assigned by God. So after 18 months, Paul, he moves on to the next place. And after him comes someone else, a man named Apollos, who was a first century Alexandrian Jewish Christian. He's mentioned several times within the New Testament. And Apollos apparently ministers for some unknown period of time. Now, the only reason Paul mentions this little tidbit about Apollos and himself is that some within the church were, in a fashion of saying, well, I only follow Apollos. Well, oh yeah? Well, I only follow Paul. Oh yeah? Well, I only follow Peter. And Paul was expressing something that even the seniors have caught on to. Paul was understanding that this was leading to dissension. So I want you to hear what he says in verse 5. What, after all, is Apollos? And what is Paul? Only servants, through whom you came to believe, as the Lord has assigned to each his task. I planted the seed, Apollos watered it, but as God has been making it grow, so neither the one who plants nor the one who watered is anything, but only God who makes things grow. Seniors, you have attended this school over the years, and you've heard the message of Christ, not only from me, but from Miss Beth, from so many teachers who've passed on and gone on to other places. You, in many ways, you've heard just like Apollos and Paul. People have poured into your life. Some have planted the seed, and you believed. Others have watered that seed in your life, and it's continued to grow. But you've also recognized that it's God who brings the increase. And so, seniors, I want to spend just a few minutes speaking to you about how you can grow. This is very important. I think the first lesson that we all learn when we're trying to grow is that growth is not easy, and often, unfortunately, it involves failure. Anyone who's lived long enough knows that life is not only filled with successes, but also failures. And more often than not, it includes times where we want to quit. I want to encourage you, if you find yourself in failure, know that it's not your end. Get up and try again. Don't quit. I thank God that our Heavenly Father, He didn't quit on us over our failures. I often think that God allows us to go through failures is because it humbles us. It allows us to have a more circumspect view of life. It's what many adults will say makes us mature. And praise God, all of you are on the way to maturity. If you will not quit, you'll continue to grow. Look at your friend, your neighbor, and just say, keep growing. Just keep growing. Yeah. Here's the thing. Paul says something else in Philippians, and he brings this very deep encouragement. He says this, be confident of this, that he who began the good work in you will carry it to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. I want you to be confident that if you fail, it's not your end. It's only the beginning. Amen? In the Old Testament book of Malachi, there is a passage where the Israelites were facing deep and moral national failure. And in the passage, Malachi is prophesying, and he says that God is going to be like a refiner, refining us in the fire. There's a story of a group of ladies in Ireland in the 1800s, and they were studying this particular passage, Malachi 3, verse 3. It says, "He shall sit as a refiner, purifying silver." The ladies were sitting in this Bible study, and they had no clue to what this passage meant. What does it mean that he will sit as a refiner, purifying silver? And one of the ladies said, "You know, I know a silversmith. I'm going to go ask the silversmith what this means." And so she made her journey the next day to the silversmith. And without telling him the reason why she was there, she began to ask and say, "Could you tell me about silversmithing, the processes?" And he began to explain a lot of the details and the intricacies. And then she says, "But I'm just curious, do you ever sit while you're refining?" And he said, "Oh, I must sit, because if I let the silver stay in the fire too long, it will be ruined." This brought great peace to her because she realized what this passage was saying. Even though the issues in our life that are happening, the troubles, the trials, the temptations, sometimes the failures, God will not let it be your end. He's sitting there watching you, ready for you to go to the next step, for you to grow. She was about to leave. She had thanked the silversmith for the information. She was pondering it. And as she was walking from the door, he said, "Ma'am, I forgot to tell you something else. When I'm working the silver, I keep working it and refining it and purifying it until I can see my face. I can see my image in the silver." And it caused her to deeply pause because she was recognizing that the work that God does in us, purifying us, is that same process until he sees his image in us. Here's the thing about failure. Failure will produce righteousness if you ask God to help you, if you look to him. Now, just as you're facing difficult times, if you do face difficult times, know it's not your end. Growth is often found in places of overcoming failure. The second thing I want to point out about growth, and that's it's found in community. We can never attempt to live alone and continue to grow. You need people in your life, even if it's people who don't seem to make you happy, because these people can bring the necessary criticism to help you see things that you may not have seen before. You have to be in a community. Along the California coastline, there are some of the largest living organisms on Earth. Many of y'all know these. These are the redwood trees. The redwood trees are 300 feet high, some of them 40 feet around. That's often mind-boggling to think about 40 feet around a tree. Some of them are more than 250 years old, and what I've found, mature redwoods live anywhere from 500 to 700 years. They're a magnificent sight. Now, here's the important thing that I learned about these redwoods. These trees are so massive because they only grow in groves. They only grow together. The roots in these groves are intertwined underneath the soil, underneath the ground. And what they found is where there's no intertwining, there's no growth. If there's no connectedness, there's no growth. You see, the success in your life is going to often depend upon your community. In fact, in the early church was successful because of their connectedness. In Acts chapter 2, 42 through 47, it says, "They devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and to the fellowship and to the breaking of bread and to prayer. Everyone was filled with awe at the many wonders and signs performed by the apostles. All the believers were together." They were together. There is growth in community. There is growth in community. Seniors, as you leave for this next part of your adventure, I want to encourage you. Find people of like faith. Get connected. Find a church. Begin attending it and commit yourself to attendance. It'll help you grow. And here's the last thing, the last point. And I know you guys are all saying, "Amen, please get to the end." The last and final point I want to make about growth is it depends on your appetite. In Matthew chapter 5, verse 6, it says, "Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled." I've been told that appetite is one of the great indicators to a doctor of your health. Consistent loss of appetite is an indication of a much deeper problem. So the same applies to your spiritual health and to your growth. This is an indicator for all of us. It's a test for all of us, evaluating our spiritual health. So let me ask you this question. Do you hunger for more of God? Do you hunger after his righteousness? Do you hunger after pleasing the Lord? If you answer no to any of these questions, then your spiritual health and your growth is in danger. When you go to a restaurant, you often find that they give you a menu. If they don't give you a menu, it's probably a restaurant you're not going to go back to. The menu says particular things about what they offer to eat. Now, you can read the menu, and you can get real hungry reading the menu. You can even, your original hunger for why you went to that restaurant may be increased by what you read on that menu. You'll hear lots of people giving reviews about their choices, and you'll hear people say, that looks good. And then you may have someone come to you and begin to talk to you about what's on the menu. The waiter exegetes the menu. All right, that's a fancy theological word. Really what that means is they're breaking it down. They're breaking down what's involved. They're going into what's in it. They're looking at the processes that are used for creating it. They expound on the menu, and they take you through the menu. They describe the menu. And then maybe you have a question and answer session about what's on the menu. Now, as a restaurant patron, I don't just go into a restaurant and read the menu and go, "That was great," and then walk away. None of us do that. In fact, if you go to a restaurant and you do that, it may be an indication that it's too expensive, right? You look at the price. I want to encourage you, as you look into the Word of God, don't just look at it and say, "Wow, that's great." I want you to look at it and develop an appetite. I want you to begin to hunger over it and then take it a step further and begin to eat, begin to chew. Seniors, as you embark on this next part of your journey, God's growth in you requires appetite and eating. David said it best in Psalms 34:8. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Taste and see. Now, in closing this evening, I want you to remember that God is at work in you, especially if you fail. So get up and keep trying and keep growing. Remember to surround yourselves with other believers of like faith so you can keep growing. And finally, remember to eat so you can keep growing. Amen. Let's pray. Father, I ask your blessings now upon the seniors, upon this entire sanctuary, everyone who's present. And I pray that you would stir us, Lord, to deeper growth in you, to hunger after you. Lord, find community with people of faith, with you. Lord, that we would find our dependence in you, especially when we stumble and fail. Lord, I pray that you would bless, that you would guide, that you would protect our seniors. Lord, give them vision for their future. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Reverend Michael Rogers. At this time, we would not be complete in a tribute to all of the influences in our lives if there wasn't a presentation from the seniors to their dear parents.
At this time, we will now have the class video, which is a surprise for our seniors, but is made by Susana Villa Gomez.
Okay.
You just remember what your old past said, or you got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me. You got a friend in me.
Now the time we have all been waiting for. It's time to present our graduates with those diplomas and for them to officially to become graduates. I'd like to welcome back to the stage Ms. Beth Ann Nunez and Ms. Rose to help her with the awarding of diplomas. We would also like to ask Pastor or Reverend Michael Rogers to the stage to help them with this as well. Are you ready? You guys are so quiet. All right. That's better. Stephen Abella Adriatico.
Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me.
Ryan Medina De Proza.
Psalms 23:4. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me.
Agent Irene Elliott.
First John 4:7. Dear friends, let us continue to love one another, for love comes from God. Anyone who loves is a child of God and knows God.
Akari Porita.
Proverbs 10:20. Hatred stirs up conflict, but love covers over all wrongs.
Elena Grace Howard.
Isaiah 41:13. For I am the Lord your God who takes hold of your right hand and says to you, do not fear, I will help you.
Jian Zheng.
First Peter 5:7. Cast all your anxiety on him, because he cares for you.
Mogmin Kim.
Proverbs 3:5-6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and do not lean on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will make straight your paths. Proverbs 3:5-6.
Lamar.
Proverbs 20:24. The Lord directs our steps, so why try to understand everything along the way?
Ben Park.
Philippians 3:13-14. Brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind, I press towards the mark for the prize of the high calling of God.
But love your enemies and do good, and lend, expecting nothing in return. And your reward will be great, and you will be the son of the Most High, for he is kind of the ungrateful and the evil.
Catriel Liailing Malone Soares.
Romans 8:18. For I consider that our present sufferings are not worth comparing with the glory that will be revealed in us.
Susana Nieves Mochnes Villagomez.
First Timothy 4:12. Let no one despise you for your youth, but set the believers an example in speech and conduct, in love, in faith, in purity.
And last, but most definitely not least, Vicky Wong Yichao.
Joshua 1:9, be strong and courageous. Do not be fair or discouraged, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go.
Before we go to the closing portion and another presentation, it's at this time that we are going to give our Eagle Award. The Eagle Award is the most prestigious award encompassing all GCA character awards. This award is presented to the outstanding graduating student, 12th grade student, who strives to exude the character of Jesus Christ, earns consistent academic honors, displays character excellence, displays leadership skills in class, and is actively involved in school and church, and I will add community activities. Nominees of this award must have attended GCA for 2 consecutive years, including the year of the award. And the awards are nominated by the GCA faculty, staff, and administration. When I call the Eagle awardee this year, I would like his or her parents to please come and join them on the stage as well. This year's 12th grade Eagle awardee is Miss Catriel Soares.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Catriel. At this time, we will give the charge to the graduates. Would you please stand? Reverend Michael Rogers, by the authority vested upon me by the School Board of Grace Christian Academy, it is with great pleasure and joy that I present to you the 2023 Senior High graduating class.
Thank you, Ms. Beth. By the authority vested upon me by the School Board of Grace Christian Academy, it is with honor and great joy I receive the 2023 Senior High graduating class.
I think we can do better than that. Let's give them a big round of applause.
As their first act as graduates, the senior class is now going to, well, they're not senior class anymore, the graduated seniors of 2023 are going to present a class song to you to close out the evening.
Are we?
I'd love to hear that again. How about you? That was awesome. It is my honor just to give a few very brief closing remarks. First of all, I love you guys. I know they're your children, but sometimes I feel like they're mine too. And I want to thank you for sharing them with me and with all of us. Students, at the beginning of the year at orientation, I said this sentence to you, and I want to say it again tonight. You are a unique masterpiece created by God with a God-given purpose. And we are so excited to see God to continue to fulfill his purposes in your life. And I would just like to say the blessing of Aaron over you this evening before Pastor Mike comes to pray. May the Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you. Be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace.
Let's all rise. Father, we thank you so much tonight for the joyous occasion. Celebrating all of the seniors, the parents, the family, the brothers, the sisters. Lord, we thank you, God, for this opportunity. And Lord, tonight as we close in prayer, Lord, I pray your blessings upon the seniors. I pray that you would guide them, that you would direct them. Lord, you would surround them with your angels, that you would keep them safe. Lord, we love you and we thank you. In your blessed and holy name we pray. Amen. And now the seniors will have the recessional.
When the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we'll see, no, I won't be
please
afraid.
Feel free to go back and get some photos of our students.
I won't be afraid just as long as you stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Stand by me. If the sky that we look upon should tumble and fall, or the mountain should crumble to the sea, I won't cry, I won't cry, no, I won't shed a tear, just as long as you stand by me.
loved you, okay?
You just remember what your old past said, or you got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got trouble. And I got them too. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. We stick together, see it through, 'cause you got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. Some other folks might be a little bit smarter than I am, big and stronger too, maybe, but none of them will ever love you the way I do. It's me and you, boy, and as the years go by, our friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's our gas on me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me.
Now beat your thing up, now stop, and let your homeboy hit it. Beat it, beat it, beat it, beat it, beat it, beat it.
You got a friend.